Hello everyone, thanks for stopping by. My name is Nevena and this is my first Plan With Me video. I hope you like it. You probably guessed it from the cover image of this video, but I'm doing a Portugal theme for April. There's no particular reason why, I just really miss traveling, and one of the last real holidays I had was in Portugal. I loved everything about the country, or at least the part that I saw, so I tried to condense it in few pages of my April layout for my bullet journal. Actually, I was so terrified I will mess up this theme that I only started filming in the middle when I gained some confidence it might just work out. But don't worry, I'll show you the pages I've already done towards the end of this video. So we start in the middle, and this weekly is dedicated to the wonderful vineyards and wines that the country has. I tried to draw a bottle of Vino Verde, a young white wine which is always very fresh and often slightly naturally bubbly. It's great for the summer terrace with friends, and I really wish we could all experience these small joys soon enough. I'm not an artist, obviously, and oftentimes I just wing drawing realistic things in my bullet journal. Sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't. This bottle is probably somewhere in between, I guess. The tap for this weekly page is a cask for aging port wine, which is arguably the most popular export of the Portuguese wine industry. Currently, I do these weeklies using a combination between the Alistair method and daily boxes. In the boxes, basically, I write down all my meetings, calls, events, and on the right-hand side in the to-do list, it's a very extensive list of tasks. I work on many different projects for my work, and there's so much to track that if I don't do a detailed task list, most of the things would just vanish from my mind almost immediately. So the next weekly features the famous Trams of Lisbon. If you've been there, you know it's a hilly place. And in the summer intense heat, it's too much for me to walk up one of the hills with the very nice viewpoints, and it's definitely worth going up there. So I just always opt for those little trams. They're super loud and quite rickety, to be honest, but I think it only just adds to their charm. I said I currently use that type of weekly layouts because for May, I'm already planning a slightly modified version. I'm thinking of doing it because I started using an electronic to-do list, which sends me on-screen reminders, because that's what happens when you have so many things to do for work. Writing them down just does not cut it anymore. I need the on-screen reminders. Anyways, the last I show you is my mood and habit trackers. I like using colors a lot and doing the mood tracker big and beautiful, so naturally for a Portuguese theme month I had to draw a typical Portuguese azulejos. Those tiles gave me a lot of anxiety, to be honest. I really wanted to do them justice. The azulejos tiles are so beautiful and intricate, but in the end I'm happy I overcame myself and just drew them as best as I could. They're quite simple, but I'm pretty sure that when they're colored they would look even nicer. The habit tracker for the rest of my habits is quite simple. I just use some new stamps of tea and coffee cups I got recently. I use them not because they're particularly Portuguese, but because they remind me of how nice it is to sit with one of my closest friends in a cafe in Lisbon. They have really good coffee in Portugal, by the way, and just slow down, chat, and enjoy the day. And this is the promised flip through of the pages that you did not see me drawing. Those are the previous weeklies that are dedicated to the famous pastéis de nata, which are custard pastries, the Portuguese sardines, and the ginginha. It's an extremely sweet type of cherry liquor that you can try in certain cities in Portugal. There's so many other things I wanted to include, but I'll keep them for next time I do a theme on Portugal, because that's definitely not gonna be the last one. I really hope you liked it. Leave a comment underneath and let me know what's your theme for April. Thanks for watching. Bye!